So, I would say I'm going to walk you all through how we can use different elements from our own homes and convert them into props.
Wow, okay, nice.
So, yeah, so parents are not really stepping out. There is also a limit on the number of products that are being ordered from outside. And it would be really nice to make the most of whatever we have with us today.
Okay, great.
So I'm quickly going to take you all through one of the setups that I have done, which is a tent setup for a baby girl.
Aww, this is so cute. Okay.
So the elements that are required, one is the backdrop. This is a vinyl backdrop, really cheap, reasonable and colorful, as you can see.
Yes.
This is a fur floor drop. I love pink. For baby girls, it's also one of my favorite colors.
Okay.
And just to complement the backdrop, I've used colorful flowers here. I've used three bamboo sticks and just tied them around from the top and from here, and like just spread the bottom. It's very simple. You guys can just read online about how to create a TP and y'all can do it yourselves at home. It's really, really simple. And, this is a carpet, like a little thing for the basket. So we can prop the basket on top of this piece of fur. You can layer it as much as you like. We also have this basket. It's a cane basket. I am not sure if we get white cane baskets outside. At least I had bought a brown cane and then I painted it at home myself with a spray paint, white spray paint.
Wow.
And it's always wise to just keep weights at the bottom of the basket evenly spread so that in case the baby jumps, the basket does not collapse with the baby in it. And then you can just place like a soft layering fabric inside so that the baby feels comfortable and is not really, you know, poked by the cane around.
Wow, this is pretty simple and doable.
Very simple and extremely easy to do. Like, it took me all of 5 minutes to just set it up.
It will take probably more than 5 minutes in not such pros.
I have this bonnet here. It's a floral bonnet, which would go with the concept. Okay. If the baby is not really comfortable wearing such a big thing on the head, then we have like simpler halos here.
Wow.
Blue and pink are colors which will definitely complement. Even a white one would.
Okay.
Even if the baby is not comfortable even with, you know, the halos, which are pretty light, we can use these kind of hairbands, which are extremely light.
Okay.
And you just have to place them on, like, just simply place them on like that, and it really doesn't bother the baby at all, like, at all.
Oh, nice. Okay.
So we have, it's always good to have these options because different babies kind of respond differently to all these, you know, headgears and stuff.
Yes.
And this is another outfit. It's absolutely cute. It's a backless halter neck, and you can just imagine the baby's gonna look super cute wearing that.
It's really pretty. It just goes with all the flowers that you've used, and I think the blue elements come around really well. It looks really pretty and really sweet.
Right.
Thank you.
Was the entire setup. To my left is a window, big window. And from here, all the light is pouring in.
Wow, okay.
And also, I have a window to my right. So, I have a light, little less light pouring in from the right hand side. This is the reason I would not reflector here. But if someone has only one window in the house, then it will be a good thing to just use a reflector and, you know, prop it on a stand. So that there is ample light which is bouncing off the reflector. And filling up the shadows on the other side.
I've also, I know, I've been through a place and I've seen like props, a little part of it. So I know you have like a huge collection of it. Could you also show us your props and outfits and everything that you
have? You would really like to see that. Okay.